notice requirements of the Open Public Meetings Act have been satisfied with respect to this meeting of the mayor and council of the borough of Glen Ridge. Specifically, the time, date, and public call-in information were included in the meeting notice posted in the municipal building and sent to the official newspapers of the township, Glen Ridge Paper, Glen Ridge Voice, Montclair Times, and the Star Ledger. Additionally, the agenda for this meeting has been posted on the official Glen Ridge Borough website. The agenda and public handouts for this meeting can be viewed online at www.glenridgenj.org. A public comment period will be held in the order it is listed on the meeting agenda, and instructions on how to comment will be provided at the appropriate time. The clerk, please call the roll.
Yes, Mr. Mayor. Councilors Hughes?
Here.
Lisovich?
Here.
Mans?
Here.
Lefkowitz?
Here.
Law?
Here.
Morrow?
Here.
Mayor Patrick is present. Mr. Mayor, you have a quorum.
Thank you. At this time, I'd like to have a resolution to approve the minutes of our last regularly scheduled meeting on November 8th, 2021.
So moved.
Thank you, David. Can I hear a second?
I'll second.
Thank you, Emery. Any comments on the... Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. Councilors Hughes?
Abstain.
Lisovich?
Aye.
Mans?
Aye.
Lefkowitz?
Aye.
Law?
Aye.
Morrow?
Aye.
5 ayes, 1 abstention. The motion carries.
Thank you. Are there any written communications?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. I have one written communication from the DOT regarding encouraging the borough to apply for the 2023 municipal aid for improvements to Roswell Terrace and Innis Place, since the they did not grant us funding for that in 2022.
Correspondence.
And just a quick, Mayor, just so that was a supplemental application. We still have funding for 2022 projects.
Yes, just
we just threw in if there was any additional funding, we want to have an application on the deck to let them know. If they had extra money, we'd be more than happy to utilize it in Glen Ridge.
Keep asking.
Yeah.
At this time, we'll take comments from the public. Anybody like to be heard? Seeing no one, we'll pass on. I have no comments this evening, but I do have a proclamation I'd like to read. Proclamation, Drive Sober or Get Pulled Over, 2021 year end holiday crackdown. Whereas approximately 1/3 of all fatal traffic crashes in the United States involve impaired drivers, and whereas impaired driving crashes killed 10,142 people in the United States in 2019, and whereas impaired driving crash has cost the United States almost $44 billion a year. And whereas during the past 5 years, New Jersey's roadways experienced 35,307 crashes and 618 fatalities involving impaired drivers. And whereas an enforcement crackdown is planned to combat impaired driving. And whereas the year-end holiday season is traditionally a time for social gatherings which include alcohol. And whereas the state of New Jersey Division of Highway Traffic Safety has asked law enforcement agencies throughout the state to participate in the Drive Sober or Get Pulled Over 2021 year-end holiday crackdown. And whereas the project will involve increased impaired driving enforcement from December 3, 2021 through January 1, 2022. And whereas an increase in impaired driving enforcement and a reduction in impaired driving will save lives on our roadways. Now, therefore, being proclaimed that the borough of Glen Ridge declares its support for the Drive Sober or Get Pulled Over 2021 year-end holiday crackdown from December 3, 2021 through January 1st, 2022, and pledges to increase awareness of the dangers of drinking and driving. At this time, we'd like to suspend the regular order of business for the CDBG hearing.
Thank you, Mayor. This is the first of two public hearings for Community Development Block Grant Funding, or CDBG funding. That program is a federal program, which is then portioned down to the state, which provides funding for the improvements to low, moderate income neighborhoods, which is based on census data. Glen Ridge is one census tract, and we don't have any areas that income qualify. The second is for removal of barriers, or ADA improvements, otherwise known, So that's what the funding opportunities are for. Usually we get somewhere between $30,000 to $40,000 per year with this grant process. This is again our first hearing, and there is nobody that has proposals or agencies that have proposals before us. And at our second hearing, the borough will be presenting their proposals for some barrier-free ramps to be utilized in our street improvements. Thank you, Mayor.
Very good. Anybody else like to be heard? Seeing none, we'll go back on the regular order of business. Councilor Hughes.
Mayor, tonight I have a resolution and then two ordinances for first reading. First is resolution 143-21. Be it resolved that the following claims are approved and warrants are drawn for the same, and be it resolved that the financial officer of the borough is hereby authorized to issue the payroll for the borough employees for the pay date as of December 1, 2021. Mayor, I move the resolution.
You've heard the resolution, Mayor. You're second?
Yeah, I'll second.
Thank you, Councilor. Any discussion on the resolution? Seeing none, will the clerk please call roll?
Yes, sir. Councilor Hughes?
Aye.
Kostovich?
Aye.
Nance?
Aye.
Lefkowitz?
Aye.
Law?
Aye.
Mara?
Aye.
Six ayes, no nays, the motion carries.
And then, Mayor, before I introduce the resolution, the next two ordinances, rather, Mike, could you walk us through why we're seeing these ordinances tonight as opposed to not later in the year when we normally would?
This is so the table, we've usually adopted them now, so the table, we did last year, so the table's set, so there's not a, the January, or the, yeah, January salary is already set, they won't be getting a retroactive check.
I think we normally do it retroactively, and we haven't seen the amount of the increase. I mean, this is the first I've seen this. I haven't seen this before. I mean, these numbers, so I don't know what's in it. Is this a 3% raise?
3%.
It's a 3% raise?
3%, consistent with...
what we did last year?
Yeah.
Mayor, have you considered this?
I've seen it, yeah. I believe I've seen it.
So I don't
but I think that if anybody would like to put it off, then maybe we should.
I mean, I think 3% seems reasonable given the rate of inflation this year, but...
So we approved, the council approved two meetings ago the 3% raise for CWA by resolution. This is just implementing it, so the salary ordinance.
Right, but we also have management. I mean, I know the right. CWA is for contract, but this is for management. I haven't seen this
right.
before.
So yeah,
we haven't even done our budget yet, where we've looked at what we were going to do. This is catching me a little bit by surprise.
Okay.
You know, so when we came, I know that I have spoken to Mike about this. When we felt that the administration should get the same as the CWA, 3%. So I know we spoke about it, but I was not aware that we didn't.
Yeah, the Finance Committee hasn't seen this yet or talked about it yet.
Yeah, that's why I say I know I've seen it.
Okay.
What do you want to do, Mike?
If you want to table it, that's, I don't have a problem with it. You know, we went through it at the last workshop meeting.
Yeah, I missed that. I was away. Did you guys go through it in the last workshop meeting? Did you guys remember talking about a 3% increase for...
Yeah, we did. I mean, we didn't break it down in this way,
okay.
But yes.
Well, then that's fine. I just didn't know where it came from. I would have appreciated maybe a little heads up on that, Mike.
Hmm.
Okay, Mayor, so I have, I have ordinance number 1755 for first reading. This is an ordinance establishing titles. Did I get it right? For the employees of the borough of Glen Ridge. Nope. That's the other one. No, I'm sorry, you're right. The board approved, represented by CWA 1040, and fixing the 2022 maximum salaries and other compensations for those titles.
Mayor, second?
Yeah, I'll second the introduction.
Thank you. Is there any discussion? Further discussion about this ordinance from members of the council? Seeing none, will the clerk please call a roll?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. Councilors Hughes?
Aye.
Kostovich?
Aye.
Nance?
Aye.
Lefkowitz?
Aye.
Law?
Aye.
Mara?
Aye.
Six ayes, no nays. The ordinance is passed on first reading.
I refer ordinance number 1755 to the municipal clerk for the purpose of statutory publication and posting.
1756 for first reading. This is an ordinance establishing titles for non-union and other employees of the borough of Glen Ridge and fixing the 2022 maximum annual salaries and other compensations for those titles.
You've heard the ordinance. May I hear a second, please?
Sure, I'll second the introduction.
Thank you. Any further discussion on this ordinance? Seeing none, will clerk please call the roll?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. Councilor Hughes?
Aye.
Yusovich?
Aye.
Nance?
Aye.
Lefkowitz?
Aye.
Law?
Aye.
Morrow?
Aye.
Six ayes, no names. The ordinance is passed on first reading.
I refer ordinance number 1756 to the municipal clerk for the purpose of statutory publication and posting.
Yes, Mr. Mayor.
Mayor, that's all I have tonight.
Thank you, Councilor. Councilor Yusovich?
Sure. Mr. Mayor, I simply have two ordinances as well. First, I have an ordinance placing a new handicap parking spot by Harrell Field and repositioning a handicap spot near Forest Avenue School. So I have ordinance number 1757 for first reading. It's an ordinance of the borough of Glen Ridge amending chapter 10.32, parking restrictions on designated streets. So I have that for first reading, Mr. Mayor.
Okay. May I hear a second?
I'll second.
Thank you, Dave. Any further discussion on this ordinance? Seeing none, will clerk please call the roll?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. Councilor Hughes?
Aye.
Yusovich?
Aye.
Nance?
Aye.
Lefkowitz?
Aye.
Law?
Aye.
Morrow?
Aye.
Six ayes, no names. The ordinance is passed on first reading.
I refer ordinance number 1757 to the municipal clerk for the purpose of statutory publication and posting.
Yes, Mr. Mayor.
So, Mr. Mayor, I also have for first reading an ordinance that will give our police department more flexibility when authorizing dumpster permits in town. And it equates pods as well with the definition of dumpsters. So I have ordinance number 1758, an ordinance to amend chapter 12, streets, sidewalks, and public places in our borough. Mr. Mayor, I have that for first reading.
Thank you, Councilor. May I hear a second?
I second.
Thank you, Richard. Any further discussion on this ordinance? Seeing none, will clerk please call the roll?
Councilor Hughes?
Aye.
Yusovich?
Aye.
Nance?
Aye.
Lefkowitz?
Aye.
Law?
Aye.
Morrow?
Aye.
Six ayes, no names. The ordinance is passed on first reading.
I refer ordinance number 1758 to the municipal clerk for the purpose of statutory publication and posting.
Yes, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, and that's all I have this evening. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilor Nance?
Mr. Mayor, I just have a couple of announcements. I'm sure everyone heard the Governor Murphy commit to funding the Essex Hudson Greenway, and I thank the mayor for attending that event in the Bloomfield Library over a week ago, Friday. So that's great news, and lots more detail to be had. And then just as we talked about, and I'll work with Eric to get these posted on social media, but the first night Hanukkah lighting on the 28th at 5, and then the tree and menorah lighting on the December 5th at 5. So that's great. It's great to have those events. So thank you, Mike, and everyone for working on that. That's all I have.
Councilor Lefkowitz.
Yes, Mr. Mayor. I'd just like to report briefly that the Department of Public Works, among other things, has been out fixing potholes in the street, in particular, so that the way of the Ashenfelter 8K is as smooth as possible this coming Thursday. So that should be a good event, and nobody will trip up.
Good. Councilor Law?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, resolution number 144-21. Whereas the Department of Parks and Recreation has determined there's a need to purchase new furniture for the Glen Ridge Community Center at the train station, and whereas the Han Company of Muscatine, Iowa has a cooperative purchasing agreement with the state of New Jersey, and whereas the Chief Financial Officer certified the availability of funds for this contract, now therefore be it resolved that the Mayor and Council do hereby approve the purchase of new furniture in the amount of $19,487.88 from the Han Company, and that the Director of Parks and Rec is authorized to enter into this contract. Mr. Mayor, I seek to move this resolution.
You have heard the resolution, Mayor. Second, please.
I'll second.
Thank you, Anne Marie. Any further discussion on this resolution? Seeing none, will clerk please call roll?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. Councilor Hughes?
Aye.
Busovich?
Aye.
Mans?
Aye.
Lefkowitz?
Aye.
Law?
Aye.
Mara?
Aye.
Six ayes, no names, the motion carries.
Thank you.
That's all I have.
Councilor Mara?
Thanks, Mayor. Just briefly, I'm going to report that the planning board is scheduled to meet this coming December. We haven't met in person or actually at all in a couple of months, but simply because there really wasn't business to come before it, but we are scheduled to meet this December. I think it's the 15th, Wednesday, 7:30 p.m. And that's it.
Thank you, Councilor. At this time, we'll take comments from the administrator and department heads.
Thank you, Mayor. Just a reminder to the public, the Ashenfelter 8K is coming up on Thursday. Anybody that's been in the community for the last 20 years, that's a big impact. We have about 3,000 plus or minus runners show up every Thanksgiving, so get out early. There'll be traffic delays, and Ben, most of all, enjoy the holiday. Thank you.
I have to report, Mayor.
Thanks, Matt. Thank you for the proclamation. We've been awarded grant money through the NJDOT and NHTSA, the National Highway Safety, for the 2021 Drive So We Get Pulled Over campaign. So we'll also be conducting concentrated DWI enforcement between December 3rd and January 1st. So just drive safely. That's all I have.
Thank you. Is there any new and
unfinished
business?
No, Mr. Mayor.
Comments from the public, if anyone wants to be heard. Councilor Morrow, you have a motion for us.
I will make a motion to adjourn. Wish everyone a happy Thanksgiving.
Yep.
That's it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.